Everybody, it's Foster, Foster Girl Productions. I'm back once again. Today I'm going to be talking about comfort zone. We get so used to doing things a certain way because the way we were raised, the way we were brought up, and just the people we hang around in general. Also, the things that we see portrayed on TV. So we get locked into this comfort zone, which is the zone that I'm going to call it. We're so deep into this vault that we purposely forget the combination to the safe, so that we can have an excuse not to, you know, find our insecurity, get our insecurities and deal with it. We want to be locked into this shell and not face realities, not face the facts. We're so scared of what people may say, and little do we know, well, not little do we know because we know, but they're going through the same thing and they're scared as well. They have these insecurities that they have this. Sarah Jake said something that I love. She said, whatever you thought you went and escaped, God says, you're going to have to face this. And she also said, you don't get to be blind to who you are. God will peel back all those layers just to get to your insecurities. And I love that she said that, because we think that we're going to hide and not be able to face these challenges that God has already set up for us before the day we were even born. So we have to come out of that shell. We have to try to find a place of like, hey, I'm gonna remember the combination to the safe, unlock it, and I'm gonna take back that comfort zone, and I'm just gonna rip it to pieces, because you shouldn't be so locked in this comfort zone, and we're all like that. We all become accustomed to the comfort zone because of how we were raised, the people we hang around, what we see on TV, and we tend to stay in this one place. Like starting your own business, we have this fear of failing. We have this fear of is not succeeding. We have this fear of people ignoring our advertisement. We have this fear of, I won't have enough money for it to do this. Whether it's starting your own hair business, photography, launching a new web series, anything. Like, I'm just naming things that I'm doing as for myself. Changing your own style. We're so caught up in seeing people, you know, wearing, you know, the Michael Kors belts, the Michael Kors purses, polo t-shirts, Jordans, and we're so scared to get out of our comfort zone and go, you know, wear something else like Aldo and other things that people don't normally see every day. Well, it depends on where you live, and people are there. You're scared of what people are not accustomed to seeing every day in everyday life. I'm speaking in a crowd of people. I have that problem as well, and I try to, you know, block it. I say, hey, I'm not doing this. And so, but you can't really just be like, I know I don't have a choice. I have to speak in front of crowds of people. I have to do certain things that deals with speaking. And people may say I speak well, but that's a comfort zone that I have. I would prefer to, you know, speak when no one's around, you know. We're so afraid of failing and what people may say. We tend to lose the combination to our code, which is our comfort zone. When God places a seed in your life, it's up to you to water it. It's up for you. It's up to you to tend to it, to nurture it, to nurture it, and let it grow. Sometimes we try to go around for what God has given us. And what God has not given us, which is a spirit of fear. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. We shouldn't have the, and I'm speaking to myself, we shouldn't be so afraid of these comfort zones. Sometimes I tend to be afraid to speak of my past on homosexuality because of the way I may think people may take it, because of the people I know that seen me be with different females and seeing the way I dress like a guy and back and forth in and out of the church and in and out of that lifestyle. And I tend to think about the past and get so wrapped up like, man, nobody's going to send me. They're not going to really think that I'm free of this. But God has been sending certain people in my life to prophesy to me and say, Christian, you are free from this. Where I'm sending these people so that you can see, hey, you have to help them to get out of this lifestyle, because I want them to see my face. I want them to be able to, you know, live in heaven and see the people that they hung out with on earth, you know. So you have to, basically, I have to break out of that comfort zone of not worrying about what people are going to say and what people are saying, in a sense. God is constantly reminding me that I can't be afraid of that, because at the end of the day, their blood is going to be on my hands if something was to happen. If I don't go and tell them, hey, you don't need to do this, you don't need to do that, and say, for instance, they just get shot or something, and I'd be like, man, I should have went and spoke to them. That's why I'm on Snapchat all the time. I'm on Instagram all the time, and I'm speaking about God, because at the end of the day, I mean, I want you guys to be saved. So that's a comfort zone I have to break out of myself. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, not lean on to your own understanding. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. This is daily scripture. This is scriptures you can say daily to help you out. We all know the story of Noah when God said, hey, go get one female animal, one male animal, bring them on the ark, gather up all the people, gather up your family, because I'm about to send a great flood. And we're so afraid of building our own ark because of the people around us do not believe in us or believe that it can come true. However, God will always win the battle at the end as long as you follow his orders, as long as you stay in his will and stay prayerful. All of these things will come to pass in your favor. The parts that you're trying to hide and not expose is the exact parts that God wants other people to see. He wants you to live out that purpose of your life. He wants you to live out that will. My comfort zone is hiding the fact that I was in homosexuality. Although I was out and people knew, I tend to try to hide it, and because I don't want people to know. But it's like you can't hide from that if everybody already knew. So it's like I have to come out of that comfort zone myself and say, hey Christian, you have to tell your story, you have to tell your testimony so others that may be set free. And that may not necessarily be your comfort zone that you're dealing with, but your comfort zone may be, you know, starting your own business and being afraid of what people are gonna say. Step out of your comfort zone. Don't be afraid of fear of feeling of what people are gonna say. You will prosper, you will succeed. This is pretty much it, Father God. Thank you for allowing me to deliver this message today, oh God. Allow your people to be able to step out of their comfort zone and be able to do what you have called them to do. Let them to be able to peel back those insecurities. In your mighty name, in Jesus' name, amen. If you have any questions, you can follow me on Instagram at foster_FOS_. This is Foster Girl Productions. Signing out.